Hello guys, welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. Now in this video we are going to talk about how do you change localhost to custom domain name in IIS. So example is what you see here. Now you see I have cell.com, so www.cell.com, and when you visit that page you're gonna have this. So let's see, now www.cell.com, then I have my port, then it's open. So how do you change this in a localhost? I haven't bought any server, any domain name. I'm using the domain name in localhost, that is the IIS. So how do you change that? That is what I'm going to talk about. Now in the last two previous videos, we've talked about one, how do you set your application on the network for people to have access to, okay, and how to deploy your application on the IIS as well. So you can check those videos out to actually have enough knowledge on that. Now let's get going with it. So first of all, let's launch our IIS. Now the IIS, when we launch it initially, you can see we have this. Now right click on go to application pool, right click and go to add application pool. So now give it a pool name and now choose the pipeline as integrated, click on OK to add it. Now once you are done, right click on it like this and go to advanced settings, and now let's change the identity here, click on that, change from default to your local server, local system. So initially it is on application pool identity, change it to local system, and now click on OK. So you may have local system like this. Click on OK to save it. So you must have something like the application pool. We have a status supposed to be started. This is the version. We have a management pipeline that's integrated, and what here you can see the identity. You must have a local system. So you can see here we have zero item here, so this means that you have no application in it. How do you add application here? So let's go and add application. So right click on the site, now go to add website, and now let's give it a name, site name. Okay, now here we're going to choose the application pool and go in there and now choose the one that we created, that is a cell ID. Click on OK. You have chosen it. Now this is a physical path, so the application that you've published, if you don't know how to deploy or how to publish it, check the other two previous video, talk about that. Now let's go to desktop, and then this is my folder, this is my application. Click on OK. Aside from that, here let's give it a port, so 9008 port. Now here give it a name. So what's the name that you want to hold for? So www.cell.com, that is the name. When you're done, click on OK and you're done with that. Now the next thing to do here is right click on the project that web that is cell, go to add application, and I'll add an alias. So here you can add app, any name at all, and now to make sure the application pool is chosen here. Now the same thing, select the physical path, so desktop, and now cell add, click on OK. You have it over there, and I'll click on OK. You added the application as well over here as this. Okay, now the next thing to do here is we need to actually check or make a configuration in the host. So let's go to File Explorer. So go to this computer, double click on local disk, go to double click on my Windows, and now search in for system 32. So system 32, that is it, open it, and now search for device drivers. So device drivers over here, so drivers, open that and go to click on or open etc. Like, so we have host here, so open with any editor at all. So here I'm opening with code. Make sure when you open, you may have to open it in an administrator mode. So you see 127.0.0.1, we just have to add the name, so www.cell.com, and that's all. So just add this. When you're done, save it. So you can see now this is instead of the local host, you're replacing it with the www.cell.com. So when you call the cell.com, it means you are calling the local host. That is a simple thing to do. All right, so once you are done, click on save and now close it. So now come back to your web browser. Now let's clear the cache. So go to history. Now let's clear the history. So clear browser history. Let's clear everything. All right, so it's been cleared. Now let's close all this and I'll open a page and I'll type in www.cell.com, then semicolon, pass in the port number, so that's the 9000, that is the port, hit on the enter key, unless it's going to open. So we see that we're able to change the IP address instead of the 127.00.1 or the local host, you change to the cell.com over here. Alright, so that is it for this video. This is a simple video to actually know how to change the username, change the IP address here to a custom domain in IIS. Thank you guys for watching. I hope this you enjoyed this video. If anything, can comment it over there. Then if you have any problem, we'll see you together. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.